Chinese tourists have been set off for traveling.
没有什么计划，订好酒店我就来了。一本小红书，出门之前做攻略。八块，你点一下。
In recent years, the way Chinese people travel has totally changed with the rise of social media. Traditional travel experiences no longer satisfy them. Check-in style tourism is increasingly popular, spreading from domestic to overseas destinations as the number of visa-friendly countries increases for Chinese people. Starting in December 2023, Chinese citizens have been allowed to enter Malaysia without a visa. A young couple from Shanghai, Dong Kai and Chao Ying, seized the chance to embark on a six-day trip to Malaysia.
我们这次行程一共是去了两个城市，先去了槟城，然后在槟城我们做很多的计划，很具体的一些细节。乔治镇打卡点，以及后面升旗山都很漂亮。对，然后来吉隆坡这边的话，肯定是以双子峰为主。 对，我们在找各种机位去跟他合照或者拍照，因为刚好我假期之前时间充裕一点，所以我做攻略比较多一点。我用小红书会更多一些，然后会结合一些其他社交媒体啊，像抖音啊之类的平台，去做一些补充这样子。We
have a generational change in China right now because the older generation will travel in groups, right? They go to Europe and then they visit eight or 10 countries together. They come to Southeast Asia, then they visit Singapore, Malaysia, Thailand together, right? So this is the old traditional way of traveling. But the new way, of course, is very different. What we call individual or family travel. They follow the internet prepared set of travel itinerary before they embark on a new travel.
Like Johai said, changing travel preferences spring from the development of the internet. Social media platforms have become the new guidebook for young Chinese people in recent years. Posts on social media reveal the rich culture and stunning landscape of Malaysia in great detail, while the country previously was just one of the countries, including Singapore and Thailand, which Chinese tourists visited all in one go. As tourists capture and share the highlights of their trip on social media, a vast swathe of travel information is also being generated.
The social media is very helpful. You no need to send brochures, no need to send pamphlets. People know where is the country, how do I go, what do I want to see, and what do I want to enjoy.
The vast number of experience sharing posts on social media has not only narrowed the information gap, but also kindled young tourists' wanderlust. At the end of 2021, the China-Laos Railway started operation. Ding Tian, a tourism professional working in Yunnan, and his girlfriend saw posts on social media about traveling to Laos by train and made up their minds to get on board.
前半个月是在网上看过一些攻略，然后这边来根据自己的一些时间来安排的，一般不跟团，都是自由行，就是自己看一些攻略，然后自己来看怎么制定一些行程，我都会去自己判断。In
February 2024, the China Tourism Academy released the report on development of outbound tourism in China for 2023 to 2024. Which showed that the number of outbound tourists exceeded 87 million in 2023 and is expected that it will grow to 130 million in 2024. As more Chinese tourists travel guided by social media posts, some restaurants are noticing the change. In Jalan Alor Food Street of Kuala Lumpur, you'll spot a restaurant with a bright yellow sign. It's been getting attention on Chinese social media and is popular among Chinese tourists. Two employees, each with over 40 years' experience at the restaurant, kindly shared their thoughts with us. In 2023, the three trending travel topics on Chinese-originated social media were traveling as a local, micro-vacation, and niche holidays. This suggests that tourists now prefer exploring the streets and alleys of a city at a relatively slower pace rather than visiting traditional tourist spots directly.
在老城区那边有很多小的咖啡店，或者一些文比较文艺的店铺，都是年轻人在开的。他们对于自己的家乡非常非常骄傲，包括做一些很漂亮的文创用品的设计之类的。我觉得年轻人回到自己家乡，然后反哺家乡，也是一个很棒的一个事情。
The younger generation mostly speak quite okay English. They will spread out and visit some of the rare small places, and they will explore the food, you know, the different natural beauties, and also other literary places that they would like to visit. So this will change the style of visits, and also I think that will increase both the volume and the expenditure, and also interactions with local people.
New tourism models have unlocked new perspectives for travelers. When sightseeing transforms to observation, connections between people from different countries are enhanced.
I think people-to-people connection will help both sides to have better understand each other's position, and then that will ultimately contribute to the peace and stability of the region.
In the age of social media, beautiful things spread exponentially. Dong Kai and Chao Ying, who traveled to Malaysia, as well as Ding Jian, traveling to Laos, can easily share their experiences of encountering a different civilization. The friendship between countries is truly forged while relishing a coffee shop owner's story in the novel experience of crossing a border by train and in the yearning to visit the country again, which also drives the bilateral relationship towards a shared future.